Papa.
Probably yeah, make put the right mic on for you. All right, you good now?
Yes, Papa.
So how things going, boy? It's a yeah, I see you.
Yeah, man.
It's been so long. You actually left your key at the station.
Yeah, I
imagine this man left his spare key at the radio station. It took him a whole year to come back to get the station, boy.
Yeah, tied up.
Yeah, for real. So what's new with you? You had your releases last year. This year you back again. What happened between then and now?
Well, between then and now is a whole different vibe, whole different ball game, because I have a whole different team behind me. Yes, actually right now I'm feeling really comfortable because I have someone like a mentor, like Rankin Morgan, who's there coaching me along the
nice
way, yeah, and stuff. Yeah, so back then I didn't really have someone to show me the guidelines, but right now with having him right now that I feel more comfortable and
very. So it's more ease for
it's
you.
More of an ease for me now. Yeah, yeah. Like, finally I feeling like
you get to concentrate on music only, right?
Yeah.
That's a good vibe. Because a lot of artists nowadays, the issue is, boy, they have to actually, you know, think about doing this, doing that, making those phone calls. But when you have somebody that backs you up, it really complements what you want to accomplish in the industry, right?
Rankin goes as far as to even adjusting my attitude, you know.
Yeah, yeah, oh boy.
Even talk to me and tell me so and so is not the way, and you know you have to be that's the right approach. And
yeah,
when he goes right down to that level, with
it's
me. So that's why I really feel appreciated.
Yeah, discipline is core, it's fundamental. So it's good to know that, you know, somebody you know is there with you to show you how to do things the right way.
Yeah,
how does it feel?
Feels great.
Feels great?
Yes, some people might say, you know, it might feel, you know, less of a man, but to me, actually, it feels great to actually have someone.
Why would somebody say it makes you feel less of a man?
Because some people might want to make their own decisions, you understand?
Yeah.
You know, some arrogant people.
Yeah. You know, advice I could give you is, it's about you, not about them.
Yeah, man.
You understand? When you make your money and stuff, it goes in your pocket, not their pocket.
Yeah. Yeah.
Either your real friends, they would understand the transition with you being a more mature artist. So don't mind anybody, no matter what they have to say about you. Just, you know, continue to progress and learn the business on your own. Even if somebody's helping you, learn the business as well.
Papa.
You understand? All right, 2017, you have a new single. What's the name of your new single?
Strong Rum.
Strong Rum. Why Strong Rum?
Well, I'm a real fetter.
Yeah.
Trust me, like, I'm like, call me the ambassador for Fet, because majority of my music will be about including parties and Fet and rum in it. I won't be singing about rum all the time, but majority of the time,
Well, at least you're being honest then, So what's since we talk about rum, what's your favorite rum, pussy, when you go to a Fet?
My favorite rum when I go to a Fet?
Then also,
whiskey.
Anything. Whiskey's not rum, eh?
Yeah.
Yeah, but that's good. So in terms of the content of the single, what do you go in detail about in that new song?
Well, basically that I'm telling you that in this song that you can have a fete anyway. It doesn't have to be a party or to be in a club for us to have a good time. You know, we could just link up on the streets, me, you, and my soldier. And it's a party. We enjoying ourselves. When we linking, it's liquor, no matter where we link, you know, but we're drinking, you see it.
For real. Good vibe. Now, in terms of what you did last year, you know, most recording artists, most musicians in the game, whenever they release a soca single, they actually enter the arena to compete. Did you compete last year?
Yeah, I competed Soca Switch last year. I went up for Groovy, but didn't make it for Groovy.
Why do you believe it didn't go through for you?
Well, not really sure. Not really sure, but I did my best. Mm-hmm. The point is, I knew I did my best.
True.
Yeah,
you know what's good to do? Know. I always tell artists that, you know, I always analyze life of basketball. You understand?
Yeah.
You know, when Kobe loses a game, when somebody plays hard defense on Kobe goes back and watch tapes.
Oh.
You understand? So, you know, I tell artists about, you know, going back, looking at the way you performed, look at the crowd, analyze it, and see, you know, this year, boy, let's see what we could do different, boy. Yeah, last year I did that. I didn't whine enough on that on the stage. So this year, you know what? I go whine more on the stage. You know, you have to find out, you know, what happened and what you can do to improve. So, you know, I always encourage people to go back to the tapes and, you know, see what happened last year to improve on this year.
I have been doing that
Good vibe.
I've been working from since last season on myself. Nice. As soon as the season was done, I've been working, I've been writing in studio. Right now, I have some more songs coming out. Yeah, man. So
yeah?
Just stay tuned. You know,
all right, so look forward to more stuff from you.
Yeah, man. I'm also trying to build myself in an art form where I don't want to be late to do anything. Like, I don't want to be last minute at anything. So right now, there, I have my dancers ready.
Oh, gosh, why? Right. How many dancers do you have?
No, it's just a surprise. Dancers ready already. Outfits done already on lock.
Head out. What age group? My age group or your age group?
A mix. Yeah, man.
All right.
Also working on a music video soon for sure. Man, look out for it.
Nice. Man. So videos, new songs, and of course you're gonna be competing again this year.
Soca Switch.
What about Groovy and Power?
Yeah, man. Groovy and Power, definitely.
So you win everything.
Everything.
Ah, nice. Looking forward to that. Now we're live in St. Lucia, Dominica, Kyrie TV, and you know Kyrie apps on all digital platforms. So what we're gonna do right now is, you know, give us a sample of the song before we play the song. All right, live.
Yeah.
Strong room in my head, St. Lucia. Me fitting it strong room in my head, lad. A party ain't a party without rum in here, lad. Got to have rum in there. A fact is not a fact. With that gal in there, boy, they must have gal, cause Carrie FM will link in.
Yeah, man. I like the vibe.
Big vibes.
But before we release the tune, I just want to big up, you know, the people behind this song, because actually that song, I have such a history.
Yeah,
man, that song got final on the food take, you know.
Wow.
Because the rhythm is from Claude, Bassman BCJ production.
Alright, big up Claude.
Yeah, man. So I went, took the rhythm, I began writing, like, you know, with the idea. Like, the chorus didn't change.
Okay.
But the verses wasn't as how it was right now.
Okay.
So I went to Claude. Claude tell me, yeah, it have a vibe, I feel any vibe, the chorus good, but I'm missing something. Alright, I go back to the drawing board because I'm actually recorded at Rankin, because Rankin has his own studio.
Okay.
Yeah, so since I do only recording at Rankin.
At Rankin, alright.
So we do a second recording, we change the vibe, send it to Claude says, say like, wow, still missing something. Yeah. Like at that point in time, my head getting bigger already, you know.
Yeah, yeah,
I say
yeah,
like,
yeah.
Wow, what they want again?
Yeah.
So sat down with Rankin. You know, we try to change up different things. Then I link up my boy Cedar. Big up Cedar, you know.
Yeah.
Myself and Cedar stayed up on the ramp.
#LeClerc.
Yeah, man.
Yeah.
She o'clock in the morning.
Yeah.
No one there. Quiet. And I even scared. You know,